How's it going? So today we are here with a special guest, Mr. Quincy Larson, the creator of Free Code Camp. And we also have a bunch of W3 developers with us as well. So today what we're going to do is we're going to be able to hear Mr. Larson's roadmap and see how he became who he is and how he built this fantastic community for us from coding at his house to just bringing the community kind of like full scale and still continuing to improve it and actually being on version 7.0 right now of the Free Code Camp platform. So that's what we're going to talk to him about for the first, I'd say, 45 minutes. And then after that, a bunch of the developers that are here, they actually have some written questions and stuff that they want to ask him that they've taken the time for like the last month or so and just curated and came up with to ask him. So Mr. Larson, if you would be so kind, would you please introduce yourself to us? For I'm sure everybody knows who you are, but you know, just in case they don't, like this is somebody serious right here.
Sure, thank you for the very kind introduction, Jonathan. I'm Quincy. I am a American man. I guess we can start very generally. I'm 38 years old. I live in Dallas, Texas, and I have two kids, age 3 and 1, and a wonderful wife. We've been married, like 13 years, I think. We waited pretty long into our marriage to have kids, and I like to joke that if we had had kids sooner, Free Code Camp probably wouldn't have happened because kids take a lot of time, as many of the people on this call are well aware. So I grew up in Oklahoma City. I went to school to learn, journalism. I worked at a few newspapers around Oklahoma, and I went to China because I saw that journalism was kind of like, you know, a less promising field in terms of like employment opportunities, but that China was growing very rapidly. And I spent, you know, about 5 years in China, learning Chinese, learning business and finance and economics and things like that. I got an MBA. And I worked as a teacher throughout college, throughout grad school. After grad school, I worked as a teacher and I taught a lot of people, primarily English, adults primarily. And I really just became passionate about adult education. And I decided that's what I wanted to do with my life. I wanted to help adults learn new skills that they can use to help other people and help themselves, provide for their families, potentially create businesses that can provide for their entire communities. So that's what I did for a number of years. I was an adult ed teacher and I became a school director. And I ran schools in the U.S. and in China, in California. And when I was running a school out in Santa Barbara, California, our school was just really inefficient. And there was a lot of immigration documentation we had to do because we had a lot of students from like Saudi Arabia, from China. And there was also a lot of grade reports we had to handle and a lot of other menial kind of tasks that were pretty rote. And I was doing the same thing a lot, and our teachers and our admin staff were doing the same thing a lot. And I was like, well, maybe there's a way I could automate some of this. So I just started Googling around and I found this tool called AutoHotkey. And it's basically like a Microsoft Windows tool that you could use to like automate clicking on different things and keystrokes. And I just figured out how to automate certain forms. Like filling out people's immigration paperwork and filling out grade, you know, wrote some Excel macros and things like that to calculate all the grade reports, attendance reports. And essentially I automated a huge chunk of our back office tasks. And this freed our teachers and our admin from their desks so they could spend a lot more time with the students. The students were happier. They told all their friends and family back in their countries, like, hey, this is the school you want to come to. Had this huge influx of people from around the world who wanted to study English at our school. We were the most efficient school the entire school system of like 60 schools. And we won like a bunch of awards and stuff. And it was all because I sat down and learned the tiniest amount of programming, the very, you know, tip of the iceberg. And I sat back and I was just like, wow, like, imagine if I actually knew how to code, how much more I could accomplish with that. I mean, coding was obviously some superpower that even, you know, a giant school system with hundreds and hundreds of employees, maybe thousands of employees at the time, didn't have anybody who was doing this sort of stuff. I mean, they had developers who were working on like basic, you know, enrollment systems and stuff like that. But for a teacher, somebody who had the domain expertise to be able to code, that was a completely new thing. And I had all these insights because I had been coming from teaching and coming from school directing. And so I was able to apply this coding superpower. And so I was like, well, I need to learn how to code properly because there's clearly a ton of power here. And so I sat down and I started doing that. And that's when I realized, man, it's really hard to learn to code. It's really, really, really hard. There are so many free eBooks. There are so many free videos on like YouTube and things like that, but nothing is really organized in a cohesive way. There are some people who've got like these lists like, hey, you know, here's, you know, Joe's recommended list of courses and things like that. And I thought, well, that's good. It's good to have resources. There's an abundance of resources. Most of them are beginner resources or they're extremely advanced. There was this gulf in the middle between really beginner resources and kind of a desert of despair, if you will, of like you get past the very basics, you've done a few Hello World tutorials, now what do you do? And so I was like, well, freak, you know, this was, of course, very early on. So I created a bunch of other tools that nobody used that were focused around helping people learn about technology. And after about 3 years of working as a developer and learning to code myself and creating different tools to try to teach people software development, I finally said, look, I'm just going to create the simplest thing that I can possibly create. This was like after years of being in my closet, you know, just coding like 12, 15 hour days, just trying to build things that nobody would use. I was like, what's the simplest thing I could teach?
Where the meeting is actually going to end in about 4 minutes and 53 seconds. So are you in our Discord?
No.
If you would go to w3develops.org and click on the Discord link, like if you could go there and then we're gonna post the you don't have to like sign up or anything. You can just like make like a temporary account or whatever. And what you can do is we're going to, in the community chat, there's a bunch of tabs on the left-hand side. And in the community chat,